That's an oof. I thought I didn't have to press that. Big sorry, everybody. Holy shit.
Have we not been live?
We've been not live.
Can they rewind it?
They can. Let's find out. That's crazy. Holy shit. Fuck, when things don't work, man.
Hey, it throws me off. It's okay.
Oh, yeah. They can just, it just caught us right back to where we are. So they can, that's all they have is what we've just the last 10 seconds.
So we've been talking. We've been talking for a minute.
9 minutes. I guess less than that because the song was like 4 minutes.
So they can go back and listen. We don't have to say everything. They can't. Okay. To catch you up, it's Hagen's birthday weekend. He got new headphones. He has a weird cable for his headphones. That's it's a curly boy.
It's a slinky.
Slinky. We're mixed on them. We're not sure how we feel.
They keep tugging at me.
They keep tugging at him. He's bought, normally things tugging at you is okay. He's bought some of these cables for friends.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
I don't know how I feel about those friends anymore. and I did a lot of homework for gigs I have this weekend.
This could have been much worse considering the fact that I just listened to a podcast where they were like, yeah, we recorded 45 minutes and then it didn't work. Like, holy shit. Thank you, Ian. Thank you for the happy birthday.
Ian's here. I made sure he would be here.
Did you like threaten him or something?
No.
Listen, we can't stand for this anymore.
Yeah.
It's not cool.
You've been too absent.
Oh my God, dude. You only get 5 absences a semester.
And you're at like 3 or 4.
Yeah, dude. It's not. I mean, if you get good grades on the tests, then maybe. But
yeah,
we're really aiming for the really.
What are his middle names?
Yeah, that's the test.
Hagen's middle names.
What is my full name? Dox me. I don't give a shit.
So, it's your birthday weekend.
Yeah.
You got new headphones.
Weekend. Got new headphones.
Let's see what kind of stuff we got here. We have a special thing happening.
We have a special thing. We'll start with it off the top. So it's our first time. We were approached by a band in Florida called The Shake to listen to their stuff. They found us and they asked us to listen to it. And I said, "Fuck yeah, dude! Let's listen to it."
Let's listen.
Yeah. So this is The Shake from Florida. This is the song "Better."
A lot of energy.
Love that double bass.
Yeah.
You almost got hit by a car today. Would people be sad about it or would they think about the what if day by day? Or would it get better? Well, every single day that years ago.
I'm so about this like constant bringing back of pop punk.
Yeah. We talk about it a lot. We have talked about it a lot in the last couple months, I feel like.
It's just an illusion.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, I like that.
Never won. Here we are on the
yeah. Halftime.
That's the move.
We are good, big fans of halftime.
About that, I'm gonna go back. That chord change right there. I was thinking that something else was gonna happen, and not that it was like a bad chord change, but it was a little bit surprising enough to the point where I was like, oh, that's good.
So for the A and E.
Battle never won. Here we are on the app. Baby, we will be alright.
One. The two chord.
I thought they were gonna walk down.
Yeah. Four chord. Back to one. Nice. I like that tone.
Yeah, guitar player is killing. I think guitar player and singer are the same person.
Oh, cool. Trio. We also love trios.
We
Monica's
love
trio.
Trios.
Tone, the bass tone and the guitar tone really complement each other.
They do. I like that fill.
That was a good fill.
Oh,
like the vocals could be a little louder, but maybe it's my headphones.
No. You're 100% right. I think the only the only thing that I want more of is vocals here.
Yeah.
I want to check out Dear God. I'm going to check out a little bit of this one. I said play. Ian, what the fuck are you talking about? Woo! Lots of energy.
Yeah,
that guitar is great.
We said we like trios, not tree houses. Musical trios, you know, like the Police.
Why?
There's the vocals.
You're always asking why. But could you even try?
This song's super cool.
Yeah.
That bass.
Yeah. Yeah. That's exactly what I would do.
That's so cool.
Why?
That bass chords?
Yeah, some fifths.
Just roll over the eyes. And it all goes away.
Nice.
Oh, yeah.
Great drummer.
Yeah. Lots of light. Drummer feels super tight.
Yeah.
Right where it needs to be.
The power made the day.
Remind me, I have something to say about the bass chords.
What?
I have something to say about the bass chords.
Okay.
I'll wait.
Close your eyes, dear, and we'll be clear. You're drowning in the ashes of everything you.
Cool.
My yeah. Mom says you're a savior. Will you save us taking all this pain away? Cause what are God's worth anyway?
Yeah.
Nice. I love that riff. What I was going to say is I'm certain that the bass player tuned their strings before recording, but I think they might have fallen victim to what happens to me sometimes, is that just because your strings are in tune, your intonation might not be perfect in every area of the bass. So when you're recording a part that you know is mostly chords or mostly not open strings, tune each note of a given power chord, and that'll help get rid of that. Because sometimes, like I said, the strings are in tune, but the bass itself might not be totally in tune.
Yeah, man, fuck instruments. That's crazy.
Yeah, it sucks.
I had just stopped by our place of work earlier, mm-hmm. and someone was working on a bass, and they were telling me that you have to take the neck off of some of those for the truss rod.
Yeah,
I'm like, that is stupid.
Mine.
Yeah, yours is one, and yep. there's another one too that they were working on today that I was like, oh my god, that is so fucking stupid.
Yeah,
that is unbelievable.
It's really annoying.
Yeah,
and there are times when it's just like your intonation is perfect, and then like you play the strings long enough. If older strings don't tune as well, you know that.
Yeah,
but it can make you think your intonation's off.
Yeah,
and it's just you need new strings or a setup.
Yeah, I mean, I think that like. When it comes to stuff like that, it's like sometimes it's just so hard to like even recognize that's even happening because it's such a minute thing.
Oh yeah, and by no means are the chords in the song like really out of tune. I only hear it because my ears are super sensitive to that stuff.
Yeah, I think like the similarly like the singer, like killer voice.
Yeah.
I like as soon as the band gets loud though, instantly drowned out.
Yeah.
But I think that like the riff in that last song, Dear God, is awesome. The energy in both songs is great. So these are, I guess they're releasing an album called Where Summer Never Ends.
So these are singles from the upcoming.
Yeah, it looks like these are singles from Where Summer Never Ends.
That's a great album cover.
Yeah, I think it's really appropriate for the style of music too. So if you are in the Florida area or know anyone in the Florida area, I would definitely suggest you check out The Shake. And actually, this weekend they are playing 3 shows.
Wow, yeah. Busy.
They're playing at Matthews Brewing tonight. Black Flamingo Brewing tomorrow, and then a play called it's a yacht club. It's I guess it's a bar, but it's called Atlantic Avenue Yacht Club. This is all I guess all over different parts of Florida.
If you're in the Florida area, go check out The Shake.
Yeah, super cool. It's funny too because they DM'd us and we were talking, and they're like, are you guys in Florida or like East Coast? And I was like, no, we're in Texas. He's like, oh, we were just in Texas. I'm like, wow. Oh shit. Next time, then.
I like on their... So the last year, they released something that says, It's Better Live. That's the name of it. It's Better Live.
I love that.
Love that.
Yeah.
And at the bottom of their profile, it says, Like it or not, we look good on stage.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. With like with the artist picture being the drummer like pointing at you with the drumstick. Yeah, it's great. Check out The Shake. Check them out.
Thank you for sending this in. Thank you for telling us to listen to it. And as you can see, we'll do it.
Yeah.
So, and for anyone watching that might have music that they want us to hear or talk about, send it in. Send us a DM.
Yeah, please send us DMs or like comment on the video, anything like that at all, just so we can like, you know, we'll follow, we'll check it out, all that good stuff. We definitely want to support, we want to listen as much as we can. Not the biggest following in the world we have, but at least we're going to support and show everybody what you got. So.
Yeah.
Cool. Awesome.
So thanks to The Shake.
Yeah, thanks to The Shake. And just like what Dave said, if you have music or if you have friends that are musicians, send them this way too.
Yeah.
We'll happily listen to it. And if people want like really harsh critiques, we got that too. Don't worry. okay, cool.
Yes, we do.
Oh, right. Isn't there there's a new Olivia Rodrigo song today.
Oh, yay.
Fuck you.
All right, here we go with the harsh critiques. The last one we listened to from her, a new single, was a ballad that had some cicada hi-hat.
I've grown to really like that song. But
have you re-listened to the Kelly Clarkson one with the same kind of arrangement?
Yeah, it sucks. No. This one was like the ballad, and then it like goes into. It is. I can't remember if it is cicada hi-hats, but it has like the kick after that in verse 2 that feels like it's not a ballad anymore. Kind of goes back down in like the second chorus, and then like tries to come back up, but also feels like I don't know. It's like the thing that a lot of these pop songs are doing is like they're kind of splitting their songs up into like, well, what if we did this, and what if we did this, and what if we did this, and it's like, yeah, we like as teenagers remember writing songs and trying to glue pieces of ideas together to create a song.
I've got 5 riffs. Let's make a song.
Exactly. Yeah. My favorite band, Between the Buried and Me, they've admitted to doing shit like that. They like, you know, it's like they someone had an idea and then someone had this idea. It's like, well, we could try to figure out how to connect those.
Do you think that has anything to do with the conscious effort to hold the attention of the listener? Mm. Because it could, in a sense, one song could feel like several songs, and there might be something to that where, you know, the average listener of a certain demographic or age range might not have the patience to listen to a full song that has similar texture throughout.
That might be it. I know that with Vampire in particular, the first single she put out, the main thing that everybody hears is just that chorus.
Yeah.
That's what they've been. It's not even like a 15-second TikTok, you know? So,
yeah. Band on the Run, Ian said Band on the Run is a great example of that.
Yeah.
And he's so right.
So this is a Bad Idea, Right? By Olivia Rodrigo.
Hey. Hi. Hi.
Hi. Hi.
Oh, I like this.
Yeah.
what happened to me.
Just wait until.
So help me God if it goes to halftime and there's cicada, I'm turning it off.
Seeing you tonight, it's a bad idea, right? Seeing you tonight, it's a bad idea, right? Seeing you tonight, it's a bad idea, right? Seeing you tonight. Fuck it, it's fine. Yes, I
know that he's. It's a bop, it's a yarder.
This is a yarder.
Oh, and the shake where that was yarders too.
Definitely a yarder, yeah. Maybe a mosh pit yarder.
Yeah. Oh, I thought the song shut off for a second. That
was crazy. Yeah, this is great.
Anytime anybody wants to use the lyric "stop" in a song and do a stop, it will always make me happy.
That's really good. That's really good.
Can't deny it.
You know, I was of course always gonna listen to Guts, her next album when it comes out.
Yes.
But I'm especially excited now. That is a bop. Holy shit.
That's good.
That's gonna be the. We got the song of the summer right here, boys. We got the song of the summer.
Slow down, birthday boy. Let's listen to Fred again.
Hold on, wait.
You going back in?
No.
Oh, okay.
Do you know who Fred again is?
I have an idea.
I don't know who this is. I have no idea who Fred again is.
He's a producer.
Okay.
I want to say producer and DJ from what I know, but I think a part of his thing is that he creates music extremely quickly.
Okay, cool.
I was watching the Ed Sheeran documentary, and he and Fred again were working together.
Okay, cool. Man, I don't know I know a few of these names. This is crazy.
It's because you're getting old.
Oh, man. Fuck off.
You know Kelsey Ballerini, right?
Yeah. I adore you, Fred again.
You're so much better at everything. Nice and clover in my chair. There's no compare. I adore you. Ooh, I adore you. I came first, but you're ahead beyond your years.
I don't know where beat one is.
Might be premature, but I'm thinking yarder.
It's definitely a yarder.
This could take an easy. This could go any direction.
Yeah. Could fly out into.
This could take a left turn away from the yard and into depression.
Into yes. When you pray or answer, you walk through life just like a dancer. A bongji or?
And I pray, may you never. We got a vibe today.
I'm
so
proud of all that you are. I'm proud of all that you are. Look at those shoulders you just had going. Oh, yeah.
Oh my god. Dude. That's the song of the summer Oh my god. That's the song of the summer
Feel
right
good
there.
End of the summer.
Dude, holy shit. That was great. That was really good.
That's cool, right? Makes me want to listen to more Fred again.
Yeah, I really want to listen to more Fred again. That was awesome.
Yeah.
Oh my god. I loved that.
I think it was, I saw a clip of him where he was, the crowd was, he was DJing in a crowd, like on the floor, and the crowd was bouncing up so much up and down that his table was falling over.
Oh my God.
And they had to like have people hold his DJ deck.
Jeez. Okay. I'm picking this one.
Oh, okay.
Okay. So I don't.
Oh.
Yeah. Lawrence released a new song. Back in 2021, the lead singer, she put out a video of her playing ukulele and singing this song. And then now 2 years after that video, she is now releasing the song. I'm confident that I'm insecure. The video is super cute, and I've heard like a snippet of the song, but I haven't heard the whole thing. So
okay, let's hear.
I love Lawrence.
Well, shucks, I think I need to go to therapy, but I'm tough.
Me too,
so
girl.
I'm just gonna cry in bed for free, but enough. Like maybe I've been living in denial for a while. It sucks. My brain tells me to eat a bag of dicks, and I suck. Knowing when my mind is playing tricks,
me
now
too,
I'm
girl.
Stuck. How come it didn't tell me before? I'm confident that I'm insecure.
Oh, that's great.
I'm confident that I'm insecure. I'm not Z, don't wanna know what death is all about, but I need to know that if I die,
what,
that
like,
you'll be
restraint.
Proud of
I
me.
I know. What restraint from the band?
And
oh my
everything
God.
You hope that I would be.
Yeah, we could play a lot more. We're not
but
gonna.
I'm weak. Oh. Criticism knocks me to the ground when I speak. I don't like hearing words that's coming
texture,
out.
Texture, people.
Please.
It's about texture.
How come you didn't tell me this before? I'm confident that I'm insecure.
Here's all the jazz bros at the show.
I'm confident that I'm insecure.
And anytime something cool happens, they go, oh!
Pre-lesson.
Insane.
That was extremely enjoyable, to say the least. But my God, did they pace themselves.
Yeah. Oh my God, that was crazy.
So scrumptious.
Holy shit. Wow. That was incredible. That's also a headphone song. I don't think it's a yarder, though.
Nope.
Don't think it's a yarder. Nope. I wouldn't be upset if it was on in the yard. Don't think it's a yarder.
Yeah.
I'm not convinced. Holy shit, that was great.
Yeah.
Wow.
Lawrence.
Also, like, what bravery to put my mind tells me to eat a bag of dicks in a song.
I mean, lyric of the summer.
Dude, that's the song of the summer right there. Are you fucking kidding me?
Okay. Fuck yeah.
Kelsey Ballerini, you want to do that next?
Sure, let's do
All
it.
All right, let's do it.
I feel like we heard a song from hers recently.
I think so. Check to see if something looks familiar.
They say to get out with the old, begin with the new.
Oh, never mind.
And I haven't been on a date since I was 22. My friend has a friend and they say they're my type. And then they texted me once and then they texted me twice. Saying, are you free Saturday? I know a spot. So I typed out a couple million ways to respond.
That's good bass.
But I landed with yes. Shit. Where the hell is my dress? Doing last looks in the mirror. Tell myself
yeah,
I got
real.
This. I got this. But I'm back at the beginning again and now. So if I'm honest, I'm scared of looking stupid. Said I'm ready now. I gotta prove it. Got a little bag dress. I wanna use it. And maybe lose.
Give me genre on that.
Pop country.
Okay, yeah.
There's banjo.
Yeah, yeah, exactly.
There's phone sounds, which I was like, did you just send a text? It was like, whoop.
Yeah, I've got messages over here just sending texts. No, that's I agree with the pop country thing, but there's definitely a lot of that where I don't hear the country unless that banjo just comes back in the mix.
Can we go to her page and listen to her top song? Let's see if it's
Let's
see if it's
this one. Or you want to do like the most played one?
Let's go the most played just to see if it's more country. Oh, it's with the Chainsmokers.
Still could be country.
Okay, it should. Yeah, not should. Good.
I'll tell you a story.
That's straight up pop
itself.
Music,
yeah.
Right? Okay.
Yeah. I lay out on my I'm gonna check this one now.
mandolin, acoustic guitar.
Well, let's see, do we get the poppier?
I think we're going to get, if we get kick and brushes, and upright. Okay, fiddle, that's country.
She's okay.
She's a crossover artist.
Yeah, dude, that's the song of
little
the summer.
A little bit of Shania.
Yeah, I like her voice a lot, though, especially in that new song. How do I do this? That song was like in the second half of the first verse where like the harmonies came in. Mm-hmm. They felt really just like tightened together, and her voice just felt really even and controlled.
Yes.
I really like that shit. Okay. I've got a weird one that popped up at the top of my Apple Music this morning.
Okay.
So I don't really listen to the band Turnstile. I've tried it so many times. I'm not saying I'll never like them, but I just don't. It's really hard. So Glow On, that album they released in 2021. I've tried it. People fucking loved it though. Did you ever listen to that shit?
No. Maybe, but nothing.
So
significant.
They're like, I'm trying to see what. So yeah, so it says they're like hardcore punk. I get more like a post-hardcore vibe from them. Still a little bit hardcore, but I'm just happy that people are listening to that kind of music.
Yes.
Someday, just like with Wilco, maybe I'll turn 35 and I'll get the whole Turnstile thing. I'll get Wilco, whatever. But they released a new song with Bad Bad Not Good, or a new EP.
Oh yes, three songs.
So Bad Bad Not Good, you know who they are, right?
Yes, I do.
Okay,
yeah.
So I don't understand this collab. I saw it pop up, and I'm like, "How does this happen? Like, what even birthed this idea?"
I keep thinking I hit your elbow, but it's just your chair.
Sorry, I can make it closer to you. How's
no,
that?
That's better.
Yeah, I don't know how this collab happened. It was at the top of my Apple Music feed, and I'm like, "This is crazy. I don't understand how this could be." But I'm super excited to give it a listen.
Bad Bad Not Good, Canadian.
Oh, are they really?
Woo, woo, woo.
I did not know that.
I knew that.
I knew that.
I knew. Yeah, you got it.
Yeah, you got it. Okay,
here we go.
This is Mystery, Turnstile, Bad Bad Not Good.
Some semi-hollow bass with a pick.
Like, where's the... There's a gun. Where's the punk gonna go?
Yeah. And I believe in holding on so hard, but I'm afraid to. And it's been so long. Saw the mystery gone. And it's been so long. All the mystery.
It's nice. Exactly. Yeah. Yeah. Give me the punk girl.
There you go.
That's a hardcore singer for sure.
Restraint. This flute player is not showing any.
I don't really know any flute player who does show restraint.
No,
plays
I know.
On this shit.
Yeah. Oh, you want some flute on it? What key is it in? Cool. They're like, you want to know the hook? No. Exactly.
Well, that's enough. Yeah. I'm digging it. I think.
Not a yarder.
Not a yarder. I want to hear the other songs because I gotta know if there's more punk in there or if they just did a collab with the singer of Turnstile.
Yeah.
Which is fine, obviously, but I'd still want to, I'm curious to see how far this collab goes. Ian, you said that you like one of the Turnstile tunes. Don't get how they blew up. I'm right there with you. I think I've heard one song that I was like, oh yeah, that's cool. That's nice. But yeah, I just don't, I'm not. As a hardcore person, I'm just like, this isn't doing it for me. So this is Alien Love Call.
Great tones all around. That's a dry ass kick sound.
It's bad, bad, not good. Shit,
yeah.
Jesus.
That felt laid back.
Yeah, it did. Hold on. I think he's used like three different snares in this verse. Like vastly different sounds.
Yeah, how is he doing that?
I mean, he might honestly have two snares, but otherwise, the only way I'd know is just rim shots.
Yeah,
just rim shotting everything. Yeah, that's crazy. I dig it. I was more than this than the first one.
Ian, you're right. These are both bedroom bangers.
For sure, bedroom banger. Yeah, this is yeah. But we bedroom banging. We bet fader on the snare.
Could be.
It could be. It's just like the tone was so drastically different. Like,
and, yeah, I would be willing to bet that a lot of those drums are probably recorded with mostly room mics.
Yeah, I also would bet that this is not the setting where if you change the sound, like, or if there's like a difference in snare, they're gonna go back and fix it. That's just like, yeah, that's it. You know, I can't stop, man.
Yeah, I would last maybe a day with that cable.
And then what?
And I would get rid of it. For all of the reasons, it's like I can't stop messing with it.
So fucking
it's
funny.
Pulling on my headphones.
I love it. Yeah, that was super interesting. I really would love to know how they met.
Yeah,
like how that collab came to exist.
Well, like my brother Ian also mentioned in the chat that they played at a jazz festival where he's from. I wonder if Turnstile was at the same jazz festival, or if they might have met each other on a festival circuit.
Yeah, they probably met each other on something like that for sure. But
where Turnstile from?
Oh, maybe they are Canadian. Where Turnstile from?
America. They're from Baltimore, Maryland.
Okay. I've never been there. That's what I need. Boom. Okay. Okay, so here's another list of new music. That was
okay.
Cool. This is Kali Uchis on. I don't know who Carol G is, but I know who Kali Uchis is.
Oh, we got some Sun Lux too.
Yep, and we got some. I don't know if this is No Name or No Name. I've never known, but I like them. I've never known if what what the name is, but let's see. What do you want to start with?
Let's listen to some Sun Lux because it might not be super energetic.
Sure.
But he's got a lot of really cool sounds.
Where? Oh, there it is. Okay,
yeah.
Cool. He does have a lot of really cool sounds.
Ransom All Innocence.
White wish will ransom me, unbury violently. All
innocence. That's right, Ian Chang's the drummer. Okay. He's great.
All innocence. Lanterns illumine me, burning the memory.
More energetic than I was thinking it was going to be, for sure.
5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
That's some shit right there. Sunlux already knew about the aliens being real.
Oh, yeah. Okay, that's good. That's really fucking cool.
That's crazy. Not a yarder.
Not, no.
Not a yarder.
No.
So cool.
Let's check out this one.
Carol G and Kaliuchis.
Kaliuchis is so fucking good.
Every time you mention Kaliuchis, I'm like, I don't know there. Ooh.
Sign me up to this yard, baby.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Man, lots of grooving today.
I love the sound of this shit, but it's my Achilles heel. Why? I can't play reggae.
Oh.
I could learn this and play it and get the right feel, but if somebody asked me to make a bass line for something like this, I'd be fucked.
There's so much, like, for drums, there's so much, like, kick is supposed to go on 2 and 4
yeah.
stuff, and it, like, totally throws my brain.
Yeah.
Because it's not like the snare is reversed. It's like just the accent for everything is on 2 and 4
Yeah.
Yeah. Snare sounds, whatever that tom was, hated it.
Yeah, I wasn't paying attention.
It's all right.
It took me way too long to realize this is in Spanish. Full disclosure, that's you know, honesty there. Embarrassing. I just want to hear this, like, the instrumental of this.
Yeah.
No offense to the singer.
Sounds like a fence. Do you hear the tom there?
Yeah,
that
yeah,
sucks.
Yeah. Super, like, compressed.
If it wasn't paired with that snare, I think I'd like it.
Yeah. That's a verb on the snare, too. Yeah, that's good.
That. Man, there's a lot of grooving today.
Yeah.
We're really getting...
What, like, is going on here?
There's a lot of songs lots of the of summer,
groove.
You know what I'm
lots
saying?
Lots of groove, baby.
Lots of groove, baby. Let's see if there's any other names that we might...
No, you ever play rugby? Bring out the whole ocean.
Bring out the whole ocean. And what is this?
It's coffee.
And what is this?
It's a mouse.
And perhaps what is this?
It's water.
Friday afternoon.
Friday breakfast.
Friday podcast. Friday live stream.
You got to get a bring out the whole ocean. Kara said, please stop.
Kara, bring out the whole ocean.
Bring out the whole ocean.
Shrimp what? You ever play Never rugby? Play- Oh, man. If he's not well, I might feel a little bad about that. Okay, let's see. I don't know. You get mad at that mean ocean. Tell him to bring out the whole ocean.
That band name doesn't make sense.
What band
Blonde
name?
Redhead.
Oh, it's confusing. Oh, MJ Lenderman.
That sounds like a... Hi, sir, what is your name?
MJ
Lenderman.
Yeah, Lenderman.
That's not your real name.
Album Boat Songs is a really cool album.
Oh, nice.
I like that album. So let's give his single a listen. Fuck, why doesn't it just take me back to where I was in the scrolling?
That is annoying.
There we go.
Knocking.
Come in. Saw John Daly sing knocking on heaven's door.
Who's John Daly? Why is that?
Calls coming from the rafters at the hardware store.
His voice is so unique to, like, the music, I feel like. Like all the musical tones.
They took my driver's license. He's a golfer.
Stream golfer?
Still have
he drinks a lot. He's just really good at golf, but he doesn't look like he's really good at golf. This stuff it just makes me feel like anybody can sing. Because he sounds great, but he doesn't have, like, the typical singer voice.
Yeah, for sure. I agree with that.
It's all in how you dress it up.
Yeah, I mean, I think that his voice is it falls into that category that like I love Billie Eilish's voice. She's obviously an amazing singer. I defended that on the podcast very much one time. But she also really popularized this like lazy style of singing, and that's a lot of what this guy is doing, is that lazy kind of thing. But I do think paired with this kind of like country thing, will you fucking stop? Paired with this country thing is it's really unique in that regard.
She gave me wings.
I dig it.
Yeah.
Okay, let's listen to Blonde Redhead.
But the song called Before from the album Before. Watch this be like our favorite band ever. That was a Yarder, by the way.
That was a Yarder, yeah.
We are slacking. Got some hickory sticks.
Yeah. I could say or have. I was not ready for that. Warn me next time.
Harmony. Ian Sweet. Can we rewind that? Did the beat just flip?
Did it? That went too far. Fuck. Stupid.
Cool. Just barely makes it. Still don't like that name.
The blonde redhead name?
Yeah.
That's cool, though. I like it.
I'm mostly joking.
Mostly joking, but a little bit not?
A little bit not.
Okay.
Louis Cato.
Cato. I've heard that name before.
He took over for John Baptiste on the Colbert show.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh.
He's in with all the Scary Pockets people.
Oh, so that's why I've heard that name before.
Great guitar player, great bass player, great singer, I think.
Okay, well, let's give it a listen then.
That's a precision bass, folks.
That right there. I've been holding out so long. It was a P bass.
It's Rolling Stones cover. Lord,
I
miss you.
If it's like a cover album, it's called Reflections.
I've been hanging on the phone, I've been sleeping all alone. I want to kiss you sometime.
Good cover. I want to hear if this is a cover.
Forget about everything I thought I knew of love.
Yeah, Ian's the Foos covered that for a while.
Cause to look into someone else's eyes and find that it's yours that you see redefines complete.
That's great vibrato, ladies and gentlemen. That is vibrato right there.
So I wasn't ready for reflection. When she came in my world,
woo!
I was too scared to face my own fears, and I could see them in her.
Oh, okay. I could smell that familiar
breath. I'm going to this party, this yard.
Yeah, man. The guilt was strong. I would have, you know, I would have gone to the yard with that cover, but like this excites me a lot more.
Dude, snare drum and bongo or congas.
Yeah.
Holy shit, it sounds good.
In that setting.
Yes.
Yeah.
My goodness.
Yeah, it was that was again like fucking grooving, man. Ugh. Fucking grooving. That's crazy. Holy shit.
I want to hear the rest of that.
That's a fucking vibe. Are you kidding me? Oh my god, that is great.
Okay. I wish I knew if it was. I think it's Cato.
Cato?
I think it's Cato.
Cato?
Yeah.
Louis Cato. Louis?
Well, not Louis.
Louis?
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 Louis? Louis?
Louis? Louis?
Okay, so this is No Name or No Name with Common and Aoni.
Oh, I love Common.
Sacrificial lamb, scam the church, the whole world berserk. The product is a perk, Cirque du Soleil, monkey see, monkey do. Clown on the avenue, clown in the stew. No navel, no nipple, no nose, no neck. Nobody to name me a claim. I'm the best when the world blow up, that's it. Same beginning, redemptive lap around the sun spinning into oblivion. When the world blow up, that's it. Spinning into oblivion. Motherfucker, I don't care, I'ma talk my shit into oblivion. When the world blow up, that's
that,
it. Spinning into
oblivion. Is wild.
Motherfucker, I don't care, I'ma talk my
it's
shit.
Wild.
Yo. Please spin me round and round. Please leave me in the lost and found. I'm bound.
That's
I'm
cool.
Bound tethered to a life I knew forever blue. Please spin me round and round. Please leave me in the lost and found. I'm bound.
Great
I'm
harmonies.
Bound tethered to a life I knew forever Tony. Blue. Easily offended, I need a minute. Sorry, opinionated Atari niggas play too much. I'm that bitch. You sound like cat piss on popcorn. Eat the popcorn. This is Tubi, nigga. Low budget. Whole summer ready to go, dummy for me. They ain't fucking with me, but I'm fucking with me. I'm that girl invented the whole world universe. A black guy made me a black guy. Ooh, it hurt, don't it? How she rap good. She ain't work when it twerk when it. Don't need no picture, don't need no purse on her. I'm that bitch, I'm that bitch. I told you that. Say amen, bless your food. This holy rap. Eat up, homie, the beef. Only the supper. I keep some on the market. I keep some in a muzzle, cause I know a lot of these bitches like to bite.
Yeah,
couldn't write their raps and say they look. When the world blow up, that's it. Spinning into oblivion. Motherfucker, I don't care, I'ma talk my shit into oblivion. When the world blow up, that's it. Spinning into oblivion. Motherfucker, I don't care, I'ma talk my shit. Yo,
please spin me round and round. Please leave me in the lost and found. I'm bound.
Is Common on this?
A life I knew forever.
He is, but
please spin me round and round.
World blow up.
There we go. Okay,
hear me win. Cold blooded and fit.
A life I knew forever.
Thank you.
Oblivion,
got
let me win. Cold-blooded amphibian, son of Gideon. Through the city wind, I blow psalms to the world blow up. Who can't compare to, I'm my own Noah. Knew a shepherd named Kiki in the palm of a hand. The world be free, it was all in a plan. The falls and rise, laws and lies. On some silo shit, is it all disguised?
I'm like a time bearer to this late nigga era.
Gambling
really
life
cool.
So that I can get better. My metaphysics ain't fuck the metaverse. It's red alerts, I touch where the ghetto hurts. A rebel purse, she gotta carry qualities of a woman that I would marry. Sweet mother, a Elohim, into oblivion we gon' dream.
Yeah.
They said Kiki in the palm of her hand.
Yeah.
She's a Kiki Palmer.
Yeah.
It's like, come on.
That's great.
That was fucking great.
That was super cool.
Who the fuck is this guy?
Name sounded really familiar. I don't know who it is, but the name Bonnie Prince Billy, it sounded really
looks
familiar.
Kind of familiar.
Looks a little scary.
Yeah. It's like, remember that band Prodigy?
No.
Oh.
No, I don't remember that.
Okay.
Crazy Blue Bells by Bonnie. I don't know what this is. The name sounds really familiar.
What is this?
Let's check it out.
Not what I expected.
What did you think it was going to be?
Aggressive.
Interesting. Cool chords.
I don't know where beat one is.
Someday when there's time to sing,
there
a few of us will gather and raise a voice to anything.
What is he, a sailor? Sounds like a pirate.
He sounds like a that's very accurate.
My hand on my mother's hand and her hand on my daughter's. My daughter's hand on the hand of who will lead us into slaughter.
Oh, did stuff for Pete's Dragon, okay.
Hey, I have a friend who did
and
a song.
Our voice
Join Daniel Hart, who we've had on the show.
Of crazy
Daniel Hart did the whole soundtrack.
Yeah. And nobody knows my friend Andrew Tinker wrote that song.
Not bad. Not a yarder.
Not a yarder.
It's cool, though.
Bonnie Prince is a fancy restaurant back home. Remember? I do remember that. It's funny because that he's referencing a restaurant in Nova Scotia, and it's not that fancy. But in the small area that we live, it's the fancy place to go.
Like what? Like what kind? How fancy is it?
Fancier than Chili's, not close to Barley and Board.
Okay, like
bar and grill, kind of food.
Okay, okay, okay. Like, do you get dressed up to go?
Well, yeah.
Okay.
But
like, how dressed up do you get? Would you get to go?
Like it's a date. You could take someone on it. I'd take you on a date there.
Yeah. But is it like? Do people like wear like nice suits or button downs or like what's the vibe?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, but okay. But I've been there in shorts and t-shirt.
And it's fine.
It's fine.
Okay. Well, I mean, it's fine to go to a lot of restaurants like that.
Yeah.
It's just like there are some that do have dress codes, which those ones are fucking stupid for the most part. I get it sometimes, but it's like most of the time I just think that's fucking stupid.
We've dressed up as a group to go with our friend group to go get nice dinners.
Yeah, I'll always do that.
Yeah.
That's me.
Well, yeah,
I love doing that. You're always dressed up. Give me a fucking excuse to dress up, and I'm there, baby. I'm fucking all over that shit. I will dress up and go anywhere. And I don't wear like a suit, but I look good.
Yeah.
Sometimes I wear a suit. I've never been anywhere with a dress code.
Yeah. Wasn't there a bar that had a dress code in Sydney? I thought, whatever. it's not important.
Is it the same like kind of dress code that bars have here?
Yeah, like no hats, maybe a collared shirt.
Okay. I went into one. It was in summer, and obviously here in Texas, and they had like a no tank top rule. And I'm like, "Bitch, what?"
It promotes fighting.
Well, it's like it follows under like the gang stuff. Get it, but it's like, fucking, what are you talking
what
about?
What does that matter? I'm here to purchase alcohol at your place of business.
Very hot outside.
Yeah.
What the fuck? I'm not like.
That's what it was. The Capri.
You couldn't wear.
God, what a fucking shithole that was.
The Capri, LOL. Oh, so is the Capri like?
It was the name of the place. It's like an upstairs bar.
Oh, so was that supposed to be like a speakeasy vibe?
Kind of, yeah. Okay. Yeah. Everything's kind of because there's just nothing there. So, like, we have one bar in my hometown.
Right. Yeah.
And you know, we had two, and the other one got suspiciously burnt down.
But that checks out. But I mean, like, it's not a big place, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's small town.
That's why there would only be one bar. That makes sense.
Jason Aldean wrote a song about small towns.
Dude, let's try that in a small town. Why don't you fucking try that in a small town? I made a clip of me reading that one.
Okay.
Reading it in the high-pitched voice, if you remember that.
I do.
Yeah. That sucked.
That's gonna be good.
Yeah, that was how you say a bummer. Oh man. Okay, let's see. What else do we got?
We got Triple Red and Lil Wayne. Lil Wayne.
Where's that one? Oh, right there. There.
I'm mad at me.
Sure, let's try it. I used to listen to a lot of Lil Wayne.
Yeah, looking back in the past, this shit was bad, I mean past tense. You get lit and burn bridges and it ain't the last
day. This feels like mid, like, 2010s hip hop.
Ungrateful
as shit, early 2010s. Forgot with being poor,
like, that's my fault, I'll let you adapt to the tour life. Shit ain't bright no more, it's more like a sore sight. You don't adore life. You like expensive things, I like trips and dreams. My dream's really alive, you just a part of the life. Part of me, I'm regressing back to the guy who was never particularly nice. This part of me ice, I try to be cordial.
Never
I
done
feel
that
like
before.
I coursed through.
Yeah, you said you would act that.
Right,
yeah.
I wish I recorded you. Yeah. Rich people problems, mansion full of attitude. I enable shit, I ain't even really mad at you. You were such a good girl, look what a little cash should do.
Okay, where's Lil Wayne?
We came for the Lil Wayne.
He's gonna be like, I'm insane.
I'm loving your little passion, boo. Your birthday suit, keep away. I know you still be checking.
Only with you by my side.
So
never leave a bitch that didn't want me to stay. Told you if you get me, bitch, you better play, keep away. I know you still be checking on a nigga like a meter maid. Heard you been stressing, looking like you ain't eating days.
Goddamn.
Gone in the heart beating, baby, we a beat away. Every time a beat it break, it's beating like a 808. Mama say we better pray, yeah. What would Jesus say? You used to take my breath away. Now I'm trying to pray.
Hello, where's the milk?
Hello, where's the milk? Where is the
where
milk?
Where is the milk?
God damn it. Tell me now.
You do a chat good. I was trying to lead a life, looking for a clean escape. Hey, where's the milk? You got anything you want us to listen to?
Yeah. Everyone can send suggestions. Real quick, though, have you listened to the Suicide Boys?
I have not listened to the
Suicide
Boys.
Also, I would say that was kind of a yarder. I'm a halfway through. Please send
absolutely.
Your, yeah, definitely send absolutely. Your new song. You can put it in the chat, and we'll pull it up.
Please tell me your name is Where's the Milk?
I'd hope so. Or maybe the song is Where the Milk Is. Mm. Anyway, Suicide Boys. I don't know if you ever listened to them, but this is like what a lot of like Gen Z are like super into as far as like hip hop goes.
Uh-huh.
And some of it's really cool. Some of it's like lyrically is like pretty fucking intense. And I was hanging out with the lead singer for the cover band that we're both in, mm-hmm. and her son. He showed me this, and I showed. Them Spirit Box after and they were like,
oh,
I get this. But yeah, I want to listen to this because Suicide Boys is really good.
And then Where's the Milk?
Yeah, send that over.
Something they don't teach you in your temple.
Oh, God.
The gods envy us. They envy us because we're mortal.
Is that from Batman?
You're lost.
No.
Oh.
Everything's more beautiful because we're dead.
Oh, nice. That's awesome.
Nice.
Can I ever get the moment that myself is from the past is fleeting? Is that get the hey, the hi-hat's ready. There you go. Man, I thought the triplet rap was dead.
But this is like,
this is good.
This is like a punch in the face punch to the triplet.
Yeah, yes. Aggressive triplet.
There we there's like this is like one of those groups that I've always meant to listen to more of and I just haven't.
Yeah,
but they're really cool.
Where's the milk? Are you on Spotify? Where's the milk?
Yeah, I'm typing something wrong. I made this up anyway. Come here, keyboard. I'm tired of reaching.
If you're not on Spotify, let us know where we can reach you.
Where can we reach you?
Nah, just YouTube. Okay.
You got it.
Will that still come through the mixer?
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Okay,
cool. It just won't show up on the screen, the name.
Cool. Black Betty.
You don't use PC anymore, right?
No, not at all.
Dude, wait. Okay, wait. Am I going to do this right? Okay, wait. So this is currently, Chrome is open, but it's open on this monitor. But that's showing the Mac. So how do I get it over? Wait. Oh, not that. It's not that Windows.
Oh,
Windows
didn't
shift?
Work.
Windows shift.
Oh.
Boom.
Damn.
Yeah. I fucking love that. And the fact that Mac has one of those things, but it's really, it doesn't work super well.
Yeah. I'm just an Apple boy. And it's partially your fault.
Yep.
Where's the milk? Oh, we found it. Stand tall. Here we go.
I love the artwork.
It's great artwork.
I'm a big fan. Thanks, Where's the Milk? We like your vibes.
This sounds like, reminds me of Joji. You ever get into Joji?
Yeah.
Hey, Where's the Milk? Did you... produce this yourself and write all this stuff?
The voice, like, voice is mixed perfectly.
Perfectly.
Absolutely perfect.
Absolutely. Nice.
All you. Nicely done. This is great. Good shit.
Yarder.
Yarder for sure, yeah. That life sucks. But today's a new day. And I'm finding a new way. So did you do all the mixing and mastering and every, like, all, you did all of it? Let's give this a little likey like.
We liked your page, like our page.
Boom.
And we subscribe.
Nicely done.
Nice doubling of the vocals too.
I kind of like how the cicada hi-hat like kind of fades at the end of those phrases. That's really cool. All on Band Labs?
I don't know what's Band Labs. Is that what your brother uses?
No, my brother uses FL.
Okay.
Band Labs, I think, is like, isn't that a PC only? I think it's a PC only one. DAW. It's super interesting. I tried to use it once, and I was like, there's too much shit on this fucking screen.
FL is just Fruity Loops, right?
Yeah.
Okay. It is Friday, baby.
Friday.
The kick sounds good too.
Yeah, it sounds really good.
Did you record the guitar into a DAW?
Into Band Labs.
Into Band Labs?
It may work on Mac. I've only ever used it on PC though.
You're my wonderwall.
Shut the fuck up.
I know, I'm sorry.
I'm muting him. Hey, thanks for the subscription. Where's the milk? We appreciate it.
Thanks, man.
Yeah, I unmuted you. You're fine.
Okay, good. I didn't see your hand move. You did that. So.
How can I? It's so narrow.
It's so narrow.
I'll sue this place.
Oh, man.
Oh, give us more suggestions. Oh, this is
tall,
great.
Where's the milk? Everyone go check it out.
Yeah.
Okay, real quick, though, I'm going to do, before any other suggestions, I totally should have done this already. So you mentioned my brother. He produced everything on his new release by this group called Destroy Boring or Person, except for two songs. So I want to listen to at least one song off of this. So my brother is a producer. He does everything on FL Studios, and that's not it.
Yeah, I was going to say that's not it. He said, I actually got sent to beat like 4 or 5 years ago. Just popped up in my feed. Oh, okay.
So my brother makes beats just for fun. Destroy. Oh, I'm so stupid. God, my brain sometimes. But he does it like he does it seriously, but he also does it for fun and whatever. But he's worked with some pretty big names. Like, I guess this guy's got a pretty decent following.
Oh wow, yeah.
Here's the thing. Like, our dad is a musician. And I use that, I hope he's watching. I use that term lightly.
We've seen the drum off.
Yeah, I did a drum off with him. So my brother like was raised, you know, obviously like kind of, you know, close to musicians, but he wasn't like growing up, like trained a musician.
Right.
But he's gotten really, really fucking good, at like actually making like beats and songs like this. So, and it's really impressive. I watching him do it. He would wake up in the morning. First thing he would do is just make a beat.
That's
and
awesome.
If it goes nowhere, it goes nowhere. But he would just like try to make something. So we'll listen to. He produced everything except tracks 9 and 10.
And then we'll have Darling Farm up next.
Yeah, Darling Farm is Denton local, I believe.
Oh, nice.
Yeah. So this is Strawberry Sky. Destroy Boring. Good work, Darius.
Yeah. What's his artist name?
His Instagram is just Darius M4A.
Oh, okay. Here's my dad's old band here. produced as in like made the beats, or produced as in like helped mix and master? And
I think he made the beats and probably mixed it.
That's sick. Really, it's Funky Friday today.
All the instrumental stuff would be him, I'd imagine.
That's so cool.
Yeah.
Is it a yarder?
No.
No.
It's not a yarder. But we are really fucking getting groovy today on this Fun Friday. There's been a lot of groovy ass shit, a lot of vibey ass shit too. It's really nice.
It's gonna be a stark contrast to the honky tonk I'm playing in the middle of fucking nowhere later. Oh, okay, cool. We'll listen to your dad's band next too. That's really cool. Late Night Yard Closer. Nailed it.
Okay, yeah, totally.
Nailed it.
When everyone's like, kind of like, should we go home?
Yeah. Yeah. That's good.
Yeah, that's really good. That's really good. The vibes are exquisite. The vibes are immaculate.
Immaculate.
Good job, Darius.
Yeah, man.
It's really cool to just watch him do this shit. He's really, really good at it. So, okay, Darling Farm.
Here we go.
Okay, cool. Where did they record this? I wonder.
Are they Denton local?
Yeah, they should be.
Cool. Oh.
You should know people who are playing it.
Did we see them at Harvest House?
Yeah. They did it Trees?
Oh, holy shit.
Fuck. Opening. Oh, holy
That's
shit.
That's cool.
That's wild. Okay. Do you have a song suggestion? Let me see if they have, we'll just do Try. How about that?
Mills is in this band.
Yeah. Ice Cream Man.
Okay.
Changing now. That's a live record. You're great. Where's the milk?
You're great. Make more music.
Splashing in the creek till you wake up. The light streaming in my window is not enough.
It is quiet.
To keep you awake for
great work on the fucking roll into the cross stick. That is great.
Remember that guy on the road that was playing cross stick this way? So weird.
That was fucking horrible.
That should be the tagline for the record. The record is emotionally heavy, but they slap you around a little bit.
That's a, you know, I would like that in an emotionally heavy record.
Yeah.
Slap me around a little bit. Knocked him over, made a new
life for bulldozers. Great vocals.
Yeah.
Sometimes it's too much. I'm doing what I can. I wanna quit my job being ice cream man.
Jeez.
That bass tone. Hear that?
Yeah. There's a chance that Mills plays bass in this.
Yeah, that's what I...
Yeah. The couch, dog's pissing on my bed. I want to let
someone else in before I'm dead. Not with you. Not with a uke bass. Water for the fourth time. Check your look in the mirror. Tell yourself you're doing fine. It's bare feet in the kitchen. Bare ass on the couch. Gotta do something for the drive. When I'm feeling just like sleep now wherever I'm sitting. I built a castle out of blocks and an optimal.
Jeez.
Sometimes it's too much. I'm doing what I can. I wanna quit my job being ice cream man.
That is great. That? Man, drummer is like fucking working that snare. Holy shit. Have a donation link? No, I don't have a donation link set up yet.
We're working on it.
That's an easy thing I should have. I just like, it's like, we are though, actually, not to interrupt this emotional song. Yeah, drummer is killer on this. We are, likely leaning towards starting a Patreon soon though. So just stay tuned. Where's the Milk? Just so you also know, we do a stream every Monday for like our main podcast show.
Yeah.
This is just what we do for fun on Fridays, where we listen to new music and shit.
So fun Fridays.
Fun Fridays.
Or Funk Fridays.
But we are probably looking at starting a Patreon. Let me show you what everybody will probably get if they join the Patreon.
it's going to be fun for us to branch out into something like that. Yeah, that was really cool. So it's just called Live. That's cool.
He said feet tier.
Yeah, feet tier's coming.
He shows them piggies for free.
What's up?
There
What's
you
up?
Go. See?
What's up? Feet. Is that good enough? God,
this is getting weird.
So we have Where's the Milk, especially, we have something on the main show called Cancel Bucks. So if someone says a cancelable offense, they get a cancel buck. So the two things that we're going to start off, people who sign up, is that everyone gets their own Don't Feed the Artist koozie, which won't be printed wrong. and then Cancel Buck, which is also our logo, and a coaster. Once that gets started, obviously we'll be posting about it like crazy, but... yeah, we don't have a donation thing.
For now, just thanks for hanging out
yeah,
with us.
Yeah, for real. This is just fun.
So now we got to go to Harry Mulligan April, probably on YouTube again. Yeah. H-A-R-R-Y.
Mulligan, idiot. Jesus Christ.
You're okay.
Harry Mulligan, what is it?
Mullagan. And the song is called April, I think. Or. Okay, we're not seeing it. Wine Roller. Oh, April Wine. Oh, okay. So April Wine type. Harry Mulligan, Roller.
Wait. Harry.
Mullagan.
LL, right?
Yes.
And then, what is it?
Roller. R-O-L-L-E-R. We're not seeing it.
Is it on YouTube?
He also mentioned Sick and Tired of, Where's the Milk? Harry Mulligan, Roller cover.
Oh, okay, yeah, it is spelled like that. Okay, that's what I thought.
We're seeing a lot of...
Harry Potter.
Harry Potter, Brendan Mulligan.
Interesting.
We can't find it.
It's all right. If you link it in chat, I'll pull it up.
Yeah.
If links are allowed, I think links should be allowed. And you said, what was the...
Sick and Tired. Look, right there.
That's perfect, right there.
Another great cover.
Sick and Tired by Where's the Milk. You trying to play footsie, bro?
Yeah, yes. New Wilco. Fuck.
Did we listen to that last week?
I don't know if it's the same song.
Fuck. Right up on my chest. Moss is playing with my goddamn head. Just drag it. I know they want me dead. These are also immaculate vibes. Milk, you are good at the vibes, my guy.
Got A minor, C major, and E minor.
Oh, he's got perfect pitch?
I'm just guessing. I'm so sick and tired of being sick and tired. Nice.
Yeah, we listened to this fucking shit last week. Not you, Milk. I'm talking about the Wilco song.
Wait,
That's great. That's great. Okay.
Like the variety.
Listen, it's not Wilco, it's me.
He's not old enough.
I need to
Oh god.
Nice. Fucking yeah. I'm the problem. Wilco's not the problem. I'm convinced once I turn 35, it will turn around for me. I've had enough people tell me I have to be older to like Wilco, and I'm turning 31 tomorrow, so it's not quite working out.
You're getting close.
I'm getting close.
I'll be 35 soon.
Yeah. Okay.
Oh, Pablo's here.
Pablo, I was complaining about our band earlier. Complaining about
we
shoot
still have
music.
To listen to that.
I was complaining about shooting the music video early in the morning. I don't want to do that. Let's see. Oh, thank you. Appreciate it. Okay, wait. So New Woods, another side.
Mm-hmm.
And then we'll do the Shaky Graves. Yeah, dude. Funniest fucking thing in the world. The initial time sent was 7 a.m. And the only response Pablo sent was just 7 a.m. Didn't even like, no question mark, no exclamation point. Just like, I'm trying to understand that you're telling me 7 a.m. Yeah. on Sunday.
Hey, what's the worst time to get a bunch of musicians to meet up? 7 a.m. on fucking Sunday.
Okay, what's another side?
Better bring the mimosas.
It's after.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, we got Blake Mills. That record's great.
I like that bass.
Weird drum sounds.
Yeah.
Toms.
I think it's all brushes too.
I hit my elbow on your fucking chair 40 times.
It's magically cleaning now. I don't do that.
I'm just like, I'm sitting close to you. It's my fault. Touching. Is there music? Vocals? Yeah! Musics!
Water tastes gross. I want soda. Did you guys know? Water, this is what they're making you drink, man. They're making you drink water. This is actually
can't
what
tell
water
it's
looks
in their
like.
Proprietary cup.
This is actually what water looks like, and you don't know that. They're using those proprietary bottles, man. I want soda. Waters taste gross. That's a YouTube channel called Skeleton Realm. They're very funny.
Very funny.
Check them out. They're very, very funny. Finally, the truth. Waters taste gross. I want soda. Okay. Pablo suggested Shaky Graves.
Shaky Graves.
Pablo, is it actually new?
Some Denton folks on that record.
Oh, for sure. Pablo, it's actually new. Fucking
good job.
The fucking give him a fucking.
Yep.
Amazing. Amazing work, Pablo. Truly.
Nailed it, King.
He did it. My king right there. That's our king. That's Don't Be the Artist King right there. That's the song of the summer right there.
Oh, Sierra Farrell. My wife loves her.
Is it because it's the same last name?
No, spelled differently.
I know it's spelled differently, man. It's just.
Shut up. Yeah, so that's what's his name on drums? Echo Lab.
Oh,
Matt Pence. Yeah. I almost said Mike Pence.
Okay, that's happened to him.
Fuck!
Here comes the weekend. I'll be walking around talking a lot. Lord knows I don't need a reason to tell.
There's your crown, Pablo.
big.
It sucks.
I'm too tall for this world.
This is a nice song, and I just barely listened to a note of it.
I just fucking wet. Thanks, thank God for this mic. Now I'm sweaty and red.
Let's hope that it's true.
Let's try this again.
Whoever played keys on this is absolutely crushing.
Yeah.
If I didn't already say it, Yarder for sure.
Oh, cool. Pretty sure this is done in Echo Lab. That's
yeah,
awesome.
It probably was.
I need to listen to Shaky Graves.
That's great.
Yeah.
It's really good. Thanks for the suggestion, Pablo.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see what else we got here.
Blake Mills, Skeleton is Walking.
Dave's fucking so happy we're listening to Blake Mills.
I love Blake Mills.
Yeah, like, oh my God.
The newer the shaky, the better. Mm. Noted.
Noted. Okay, here we go.
Right there, it's in the top. The thing about his stuff is that you try to like try to learn it, and it's like, oh shit.
Yeah, I'm sure. Yeah.
I can't play that chord. I love the let's not do traditional bass on a song like this. Instead, we'll do synth bass.
I also love that like this ride is like doing like this like the swing thing, but it's like dragging everything. It's great. Yeah.
Linear drums. Linear.
Yarder.
Yes.
Yarder.
We've been slacking on the yarders.
I mean, today's been full of them.
Yeah. Hey Lover by Blake Mills. Dawes has a song. I wonder if it's a cover.
Thieves. Get them.
Well, they were all in a band together called Middle Brother.
Right, yeah. Yeah.
You know that.
Yeah, I was just doing a bit.
Yeah.
I get that it's part of the vibe. I do wish the voice was louder, though.
Well, yeah.
This keeps happening. I would love to hear a little more of it. But
yeah.
I know it's the vibe. Emily King is fucking great, dude. I saw Emily King live once.
Nice.
She opened for Sawa Boelis.
Sawa Boelis?
She opened for Sawa Boelis. Widowy.
My armpits are so sweaty. Look at that. Jeez. Texas is too hot.
Yeah. You should also keep hitting and like running into stuff.
Yeah. Running. Oh, Mother Tongues.
Isn't that the other Mother Tongues?
Oh, there's two Mother Tongueses?
Yeah, did we run into this?
There's only one tongue.
We ran into this because I think there was like a on one of the NPR playlists there was a Mother Tongue song, and I was like, no fucking way is that in Mother Tongues, because they've been
doing
anything
for
a long time.
Yeah.
Okay, wait. So
Emily King.
I don't think I've listened to this song because this is newer.
Do you ever miss a mustache hair when you're trimming and it starts poking you in the mouth?
No, I pay someone to do that for me. Okay. So funny.
You pay someone to poke you in the mouth?
Yeah. Oh. So funny, as I went and saw a friend of the show and our barber, Gary, on Monday. And he's like trimming my mustache, and he's like, did you want to leave the mustache longer? I should have asked. He's like already done one side, and I'm like,
it's too late now, Gare Bear. What are we going to do about this?
I didn't really care. It was totally good. But I loved that he was like halfway, like this side was done. He's like working on this one. Like, you wanted me to do that, right?
I definitely get I have to trim my own mustache because I can't have someone else do it.
Oh, because you like, does it like tickle you or something?
It makes me twitchy and, I don't know, uncomfortable.
Yeah. It was a special occasion, right? Is that what he said?
Yes.
Oh, it's the the song.
Okay, okay, cool.
From the album, Special Occasion.
Have you listened to Emily King?
No.
Oh,
or
dude.
Maybe.
She is so fucking good. Cool. She is like, oh, yeah, amazing.
Oh, with the Lucas Nelson song. Lucas Nelson's on this.
You can try that one out next, too.
Yeah.
She's a great singer. Y'all cut your hairs or you... Yeah, we're not fucking heathens, man. Fucking God.
Get a haircut.
You fucking loser.
Loser?
That's a callback to when I said that to our sound guy on accident in Austin.
Yeah.
He said, huh?
Dude, my timing is weird today because I wasn't hearing one where one is. No. Oh, God, I hope that doesn't happen on my gig tonight. Like, great job. Why are you playing in seven? We're playing Friends in Low Places, you fucking idiot. Yeah. Played bass on this. I'm gonna try to look this up. It sounds like My Friend and Yours, Pino Palladino.
Maybe. It's only love that we've got to give. Only her voice is so that we've got
to live. It's only luscious.
What a
100% a yarder.
What also, what a fucking like cock tease to like get that like little bit of that like push right there on the kick.
Yeah.
And then just nothing. Just
nothing.
Boom, boom. And then we'll wait.
Yes, that is the whole point of country music. It's to not confuse white people.
That's true. That's very true.
Yes.
Also, just to clarify, I actually was not calling you a fucking loser for cutting
No,
cutting
we were referencing it.
I'll tell a quick story, which was when we played in Austin a couple weeks ago. Our friend was loading in, and last time we saw that friend, we were like giving him shit about his hair. He should cut his hair, whatever. Anyway, he also, I forgot that he is hard of hearing. So he's on the other side of the fucking bar loading his shit, and I'm yelling, "Hey, cut your hair, you fucking loser." And the sound guy is standing kind of in between us. I didn't really make that connection because I'm just looking
at
my friend.
We hadn't met the sound guy yet.
Yeah, and he had long hair, and the sound guy looked at me like I was yelling at him. Not my best moment.
No.
For those who don't, who haven't watched this episode, you can go back and listen to or watch our episode on
Tour Stories
we did a couple weeks ago where we tell all these stories. But that was, I had a really rough weekend, that weekend of just everything embarrassing happening to me.
Especially that day.
Yeah.
That day was particularly hard.
That day was brutal. So it felt like, anyway, you can watch that whole episode to get all the stories. But do you want to listen to this one at Lucas Nelson, or do we want to move on? Ian Sweet also, we want to check that out.
Let's move on.
Move on. You should listen to Emily King, though.
I will.
She is on, which song is it? Off of the Sarah Bareilles album. She's on one of the songs, and basically like they found out that they were neighbors. And so, and they already kind of knew who each other were, and then they like came out and like they sang together, and yeah. So then on the live record for the song that "If I Can't Have You," because she opened for that tour, she invites Emily King to come out because they co-wrote the song and so on. Chat disconnected.
Uh oh.
Sorry. Oh, maybe that's just on my end. Let me see if I can still chat.
Hey, let us know if you can still send stuff in chat. No, chat. Chat's unable to connect. They're trying to stop us.
We didn't say nothing bad this time.
No, we didn't. There's no mention of Adolf Hitler.
It says, okay, it's working here. I can see it here.
Okay.
Yeah, it's just not working on our end. I can refresh the page, see if that works. Refresh that, maybe? Here, let me pull up our next one. Mine wasn't loading new messages for a few, but works now.
Oh, well, technical difficulties.
Yeah, that's literally not, there's nothing I can do about that. That is just all YouTube. Fuck you, YouTube.
Watch the profanity.
Sorry. You, YouTube.
Oh, dude, I didn't know we had that.
Yeah, dude, of course we have this. I think it like actually cuts you out too. Like just say a sentence. Just start.
It's probably. It's, oh, it does work for me.
Yeah.
Okay.
I did figure out
why this doesn't work.
Why is that?
So it used to just be everybody, or you could select one mic, but now they changed it, so it's just only on, like, it's just a setting. And I added some reverb to it.
I can hear that.
Yeah.
It's pretty cool.
Imagine cutting your hair. I cut my hair.
Used to have long hair. And I cut it. Gary cut it.
Yeah,
I used cut it into a pretty gnarly mullet, actually.
Gary cut my hair too. Okay, Ian Sweet, your spit.
Here we go.
Almost hyper pop vibes.
Almost.
I like it a lot. I like that a lot.
Yeah. Kind of reminds me of this band from Canada called Metric.
Oh, yeah, totally. Yeah. I get that vibe. Definitely reminds me of Metric.
My brother said, don't lie, Dave. Raisins cut your hair. Have I ever told you about Raisins? The barber? The one barber in my hometown? No. Speaking of my hometown? This guy named Raisins is, like, got to be pushing 90, and he's still cutting people's hair.
Okay.
Over the pandemic, they thought that he had shut his shop down and retired, so they were sending him his retirement money. And once the pandemic was kind of calm down in that area, he just opened up his shop again and kept doing haircuts.
Good for him.
Kept giving him his retirement money.
Shout outs to Raisins.
To Raisins. Raisins. That is his name. He knows everybody's business in town.
Nice.
Yeah. He does one haircut.
One?
There's no options.
Oh, I see.
You get one style of haircut this man does.
Was that last song a yarder?
Yes.
Okay. I don't know what else people can still send some shit. I don't know when you got to go too. I assume you have to go kind of soon.
I should probably go soon.
Yeah. So
beat that Friday traffic.
At the very least, we'll listen to Matthew and the Arrogant Sea, band that I'm in, released a song called Strange Couple of Birds today. And we'll give this a listen. And I think we'll probably call it there. We'll see what happens. But let's give this a listen. For those also who don't know about this, I posted about it on the Matthew and the Arrogant Sea Instagram today. This was the first song I ever learned when I joined the band. Not knowing I joined the band also, just kind of like thought I was filling in for a little bit. And then this song is finally out, and I'm really happy about it.
That is the story of your life.
What?
Well, my life too, actually. Just thought I was filling in for a little bit.
Yeah.
Now I'm in the band.
Yeah, exactly. So
see, look, he said I used to get bowl cuts and he used masking tape to make sure it was even.
Hey, that's a pro move.
That's real.
Pro move. Okay, so Strange Couple of Birds.
Yeah, when I heard the clip, I was like, oh, I know this song.
Yeah. Yeah.
Is that Tony?
Yeah.
Oh wow, I haven't heard it mastered. That snare sound.
Yeah.
September 1st,
baby, the album's out.
Mm-hmm.
Look at you.
Pathetic. I love that acoustic.
Yeah. Is that Matthew or Pablo?
I think Pablo. Oh. Thanks. Not my talk. Please direct me to the nearest. Everything I record for this band is done at a studio owned by a drummer. Oh man. It's it makes life so easy.
Yeah, Blake. Get that out front. Dude, you should have been a fucking disco drummer.
Not too late, man. That
stranger you talk. This is a yarder.
Disco game.
Yeah.
This is definitely a yarder, for sure. Fades away,
and we wait. We wait. That's such a cool groove. Song's huge live.
Yeah.
And we wait. Are you singing backups yet? We
wait. No.
We wait. Vocals?
Yeah.
Gang gang.
Right. Gang gang. Ice cream's so yummy. Thanks for the flowers. So that's Strange Couple of Birds, the last single we're releasing off that album. The album comes out September 1st with our show at the Kessler. So that's the plug for today. That's the plug I'm doing. Go listen to that fucking song on your own time and stream it so we get streams, and then tell your friends about it. But then if you're in the DFW area, fucking come see us at the Kessler for our album release show, because we are super stoked for that and for this album to just come out in general.
Yeah.
Cool. Got anything else?
No, that's it. Thanks Amazing. For hanging out with us.
Yes. Thank
Thanks
you
for sharing
out.
Your music with us.
Yeah, for real. Everyone go check out The Shake. They're from Florida, so you can find them on Instagram, TheShakeFL. And if you have any friends in Florida, or if you are in Florida for whatever reason, they are playing 3 times this weekend, so go check them out. And then Where's the Milk? Thanks for hanging out. Thanks for sending your music in. Everyone go check out Where's the Milk? Only on YouTube. Go check out their shit. They're amazing. Good hangs today. Lots of groovy shit. Lots of fucking yarders.
Lots of yarders. Yeah, lots of yeah. groovy stuff.
So, you know, we'll be back, I think, next Friday, I think.
Yeah, yeah. For this, and yeah. on Monday, we're doing a show.
Yep, Monday, we're doing the regular show, so hang out on Monday with us. Come hang out next Friday with us. Just follow us on all the socials, DFTA Podcast on Instagram, Don't Feed the Artist on TikTok, and we'll post here whenever we're going to go live. It's always scheduled ahead of time, so you can see that shit. Thanks for hanging out. If you haven't already, I think you already have, but if you haven't already, like the stream, subscribe to the channel, all that good shit. Thank you guys so much, and
fuck off! Get rid of town!
Goodbye!